Hello, my soul tribe. Welcome to my channel. I'm Celeste TT Tarot, and this is going to be Sagittarius's reading. Your happy birthday, my happy birthday, Saggies. My mom is a Sag. So after her birthday, which her birthday was yesterday, I am going to do the reading for today. So I shuffled my playlist. This is my dance playlist because Saggies just be having a lot of energy. Like when I think of Sag, I think of high energy. So I chose my dance playlist for you guys. And the first song that came on is Cry For You by September. So something could have happened in September. So I'm going to go ahead and put the music on here for you guys. Try to make sure it's not too loud. But you guys kind of like loud, so I think that tempo is good enough. So I put it on shuffle, and that's the first song that came. It's the radio mix. Hey, just get us in the vibe, okay? So how I typically do this is I'm going to start it off with an oracle deck. So I am going to pull for my Saggies the Starseed Oracle deck, okay? Here we go. Starseed Oracle deck. So I'm going to pull first spread for my Saggies. My God, what message do we have for my Saggies? Their birthday month. Sorry I'm late, guys. I've been on the hiatus because, you know, when you're on a certain journey... I am a part of the Transforming Journey Collective, so the energies have been very intense, and I was going through a hiatus, a shedding process, but the universe said pick it up for Saggies. You got to balance these energies out, so let's party, Saggies, all right? So I have here the Courageous Peony, multifaceted, unique nature, let yourself be seen. This card came out in your soul space, Saggies. So, a lot of you guys are not being true to yourself. A lot of you guys are awakened, but you're not being true to yourself. This came out in your soul space. I'm going to read a bit from the book just to give you more. And it says, you didn't wake up when we died. So, death and rebirth, Scorpio energy, which is Scorpio is in... November, end of October, beginning of November. So, and then this is like now or never, forever. Life is now or never. You'll never see me again. So who's gonna cry for you? So some of you guys are grieving, but you're actually grieving in your soul space because you're not letting yourself be seen. You're not being true to yourself, even though it sounds like you've gone through a death and a rebirth and an awakening. So it says here, flowers don't open and close according to who walks by. They embrace all of what they are and show it to the world around them. The peony doesn't try to compete with the cherry blossom, and the cherry blossom doesn't try to compete with the tulip. They own what they are and trust the timing of their true nature. You're being called to do the same. It's time to open yourself up to being seen. Time to show your incredible, multifaceted, true nature with the world around you. To uncover and reveal your soul's greatest gifts without wavering. To own your own uniqueness without apology. So we have crying and apology here. You may have been taught that it's safer to keep your light hidden and your voice small, to hide behind the bushes instead of growing tall. The Courageous Peony is here to remind you that it's safe to embody all of who you truly are. It's safe to share your voice and let yourself be seen. At first, it may feel uncomfortable. You may be afraid of what others think. But with each passing day, it does become easier. Little by little, you realize it draws in those who are meant for you and experiences you've been longing for to arrive at your feet. And then your mind space, we have jump in, Andromedian energy, adventure, say yes to change. So for some of you guys, spirits, the universe is pushing you to change and to jump into this change because it's time to let yourself, you're awakening, you're going through a death and a rebirth, and it's time to let yourself be seen. What just came on was Misunderstood by Queen K. So a lot of you guys feel like you've been misunderstood. It's time to let your true self be seen. All of this is resonating. And then in the 3D space, we have here, all paths lead home, enter authority, intuition, turn your gaze within. Okay? Because all paths lead home. But you need to do some self-reflection and turn your gaze within. No pointing the finger at anyone, because if you weren't being true to your authentic self and playing it small, then the universe is telling you to go within and to reflect on why you were doing that. So let's go read a little bit from Jump In so I can get a little bit more messages. Misunderstood, but it's all good. Exactly. Jump in. It's all good. So let's see. What do I have here? Dang, I can't find the dang on page. I avoided this part. So a lot of you guys are avoiding the part. All paths lead home, though. Should I follow my mind or follow my heart? If she get in my way, she got to get erased. So they were saying that you don't, there's no need to compete. Just be authentically you and let your inner light shine. I got a voice now. Yeah, all of this, this song is completely relevant. Some of you guys definitely need to grab this song. Misunderstood by Queen K. It's Misunderstood by Queen K. And the album is, I believe it's called Eat My Pussy Again. That's definitely a Saggy energy.
Queen shit, bitch, period. I'm doing that. Pouring my dad in the motherfucking beginning.
So, yeah, there we go. Sophomore years. Maybe something happened during your sophomore year. But you're super smart and you were playing it small. Jump in. So, Andromeda is a spiral galaxy, the closest galaxy to the Milky Way. These type of star seeds are a group of beings who love their freedom. Very adaptable, they have a strong willingness and ability to change and go with the flow, to find calm in chaos, to swim with the tides. This card is here to encourage you to do the same. So if you have a significant goal ahead of you, if so, you're being guided to jump in. Don't wait for permission. Don't stall until you feel ready. Take a deep breath. Good old run up and jump right in. You guys are horses. Like, you're, I always like to think Sagittarius energy reminds me of horses. Horses are very free. They like to graze out in the open. They don't like to play small. They go where they want to go when they want to go there. That's why you're part horse. And you're also hunters. It's part horse and man with the arrow. So whatever you shoot your mind towards, whatever you shoot your energy towards, you typically can accomplish your goals. But you cannot dim your inner light, because you'll end up stalling yourself and you'll be a horse trapped in a cage. The Andromedians want you to fall in love with surfing the waves of life, okay? So you're already facing the right direction. Just leap. Go ahead. Run off. You came to Earth to truly live, so take a good run and leap. That's what I just said. And then last one is all paths lead home. Let's see. Turn your gaze within. It's normal to look to the external world for answers and guidance. What's revolutionary is turning your gaze inward. Source your guidance from within. Study the terrain of your inner landscape to develop a reliable relationship with your soul. The more time you spend connecting with your soul, the deeper it will become. The challenge for empaths is staying connected without cutting off from the world. So you may be called to develop or switch up your spiritual practice. Turn your gaze within, okay? To start from a feeling of at-homeness and throughout the day to find simple ways to keep coming home. Okay? So, overall, it says forge, don't follow, okay? It's time for you to forge your own path. It says here, pave a new path, be the leader you wish you had. It's time for you to be a leader. So this following energy is definitely not typical of Saggy. So no following, no forge your own path. You are authentic. You're your own star, but you have to believe in it and go within. If you wait until the path is perfectly paved, you won't be forging your own path. You'll likely not even take the first step. Don't let a small detail like being unable to find someone to show you the way be the reason you don't step forward and lead. Let it be the reason that you do. The most courageous and needed leaders are the ones who don't wait for permission or until the morning they wake up feeling ready. So they don't wait for someone to lead them. They lead themselves. So you're called to be a leader. There's no one on earth who comes close to possessing your unique combination of skills, gifts, and life experience. Don't look to those who have come before you to work out your path. Leaders must forge their own. Do it for your daughter. Do it for the younger you. Do it for the leaders who will follow. When you go first, you make it easier for others to follow your lead. Forge, don't follow. So get out of this following energy, Saggies, okay? I don't know what's going on, but you guys need to break up out of that. You're a horse, unicorn, a Pegasus, like all those are types of horses that you can tap into those energies and use those as fire energy for your avatar in order to spark your own unique path. What's on right now is where the bag is, city girl. So some of you guys are stalling yourself from getting to your own bag. So you need to forge and become a leader so you can create your own legacy. Okay? And what just came on is into you, Ariana Grande. So I'm next going to pull this Shadows and Light Oracle. Okay? For my Saggies, this Shadows and Light Oracle. So let's see. Sorry, I'm moving a little slow, but I'm trying to speed it up here. This is what it looks like. And then here is the deck. Very pretty. Oracles of Shadows and Light. And you know what? I should pull those cards back out. Sorry. And I'm sorry for the lighting here. It's like pretty dim, but I like to keep it that way. So it was the courageous peony. Jump in and all paths lead home. Hey. All right, you like danger. All right, that's what I'm talking about. Time for a new adventure, Saggies. All right, let's get your shadows and light. Hey. Yeah, that fire energy. Some of you guys are fiending for some passion right now. You're into somebody. Okay? See, this is completely resonating. We have here Clockwork Pumpkin, a wonderful idea, the aha moment. Card number 39 of this Shadows and Light deck. A Clockwork Pumpkin. And that's card number 39. So 39, 3, and 9. When I have cards that have oracle decks that have numbers, 3 and 9 is like the hangman energy. It's like hangman energy is like having a higher perspective, taking a look at different things. This is in your soul space. You need to have a higher perspective on being authentic and letting yourself be seen, letting your star shine. Your mind space was jump in. And you have calm and chaos, sea storm. So that's card number 32. 32 is 3 plus 2 is card number 5, the Hierophant, your spiritual beliefs. Maybe your mind space, your spiritual beliefs are being challenged and that's causing chaos. But the universe is telling you to steel your mind because whatever your belief system, whatever caused the chaos to your belief system that's causing you to decide to shift focus, that is facing you in the right direction. So the universe is telling you you're ready. Go ahead and leap in because it's time to be your authentic self and be a leader. And then we have here, and then also card number 3 and 2. Card number 3, we had card number 3 and 9, right? Going back to the soul space. Card number 3 is the Empress card, right? You are Empress. Some of you may be mothers, nurturers. You've mastered the different feminine energies that you can have. And card number 9 is Hermit mode. It's like going within, doing some reflections. Hermit card is a Virgo energy. Some of you have that in your chart. The Empress energy is Taurus or Libra. So some of you guys may have that in your chart. So tapping into your inner self in order to bring out your Empress energy is a lot of you guys need to go within, isolate yourself, and cleanse, okay? Because that's what we got, sea storm here. I think of that as like cleansing, so that you can be able to find reconnect with your own intuition. The Empress energy again, and card number 2, which is like the High Priestess, which I look at as like Pisces energy. So some of you guys have that in your chart, or you could be dealing with someone that has that in their chart, or that's their sign. And then the last card is Autumn is my last chance. Please don't lose hope, card number 6. Card number 6 is the Lover's energy, which is Gemini's card. So this could be dealing with the love situation that happened in Autumn. Autumn is from September to roundabout November. So we did have that September song that came on. That was the first one. So maybe something ended out in September, began in September, or something significantly happened in your life when in September. And you felt like it was your last chance for a lover's relationship. But the universe is telling you all paths lead home. So get out of this limited beliefs of following and not forging your own path. And then at the bottom of the deck, we have Sea, Beacon, Fairy, guidance, but where would it lead you? So the universe is sending you guidance. As an Empress, we got the card number 3 again, that Empress energy, Taurus and or Libra, as I mentioned before. So the universe is guiding you. It could have something to do with when it comes to your belief systems. And the Libra card is card number 11, justice. So justice represents balancing the scales, equal give and take, the truth. So if some of you guys were involved in an unjust situation, justice will come on. The universe will be guiding you. And some of you guys may be scared as to where it is leading you. But if a situation that you're in, were in around September and Autumn, or that you were in, because this seems like past tense, because it's like they're guiding you out of something. Whatever's going on, all paths lead home. So you have to get out of this lack mentality mindset, which might have to do with you playing small based on your belief systems. Challenge your belief systems, go within and figure out what it is that you really want and forge your own path. Be a leader, because the spirits are guiding you that, yes, you are the Empress. You have the ability to be that. I see that energy in your soul space and in your mind space. But in your physical 3D space, it could be something significant in September when it said cry for you. Maybe some of you guys entered into a relationship that had you crying a lot, or crying for someone a lot. And the universe is saying all paths lead home. Like, you don't have to hold on. Because if you see here, she's like holding on to this apple. Like, oh, this is my last chance. Like, this is the only chance I have to have love. And it's like, all paths lead home. Like, if you truly want that, you have to be willing to venture out and step into your own power, your own energy, and go within to figure out what it is that you really want. If you're not sure what you really want, then you're going to have this lack mentality holding on. And that's what's creating a storm in your mind, creating chaos in your mind. Because there's something that has to do with timing. So some of you guys are getting an aha moment to shift your perspective, that'll allow you to brave the storm of your mind into thinking that a lover that keeps you crying is what something you need to hold on to, because the spirits are guiding you out so that you can embody that Empress energy. So let us pull a moon energy. Okay, we're gonna pull from the moonology. You should know. We got by Sierra. So the universe wants you to have fun. Like, life is fun. Love should be fun. You shouldn't be crying for anyone. And you shouldn't be in a relationship that has you crying, or crying for somebody else. Get back in that Sag energy, yeah. So you need to figure out what it is that you truly want. If you want a fun partner to have you bouncing, like, then align yourself with that partner. Like, if you like dancing, get into your creative energy. I feel like with Sages, you guys do really good with moving your body. My mom is a Sag, and we were always on the go. So it's either travel, it has to be something creative that gets you moving your body. And I feel like some of you guys could take yoga classes or so, some kind of creative dance classes. You might can lead and create a dance class, because I saw Empress here came out a lot. So some of you guys may be mothers. Maybe in September you had a child. In September you could have gotten pregnant with a child. You could have learned you were pregnant with a child. Could have in what's three in right now you may be finding out you're pregnant. You could have found out you were pregnant in May. You could have found out you're pregnant in June. You could have had a child in June or May, or even March. Any one of those things. If you are pregnant, you can be expecting any one of these time frames. If that is the case, and these could also be dates. If that is the case, Saggies, then they're like, be creative. You can lead. Like, you know, if you know that there's other mothers out there, like, forge your own path. Become an entrepreneur. You could create something. And look, y'all could take my ideas because I'm a Capricorn sun. Like, I'm a homebody. I'm a little bit more, like to chill out, laze around. I ain't trying to be bopping around. So, some of you guys could create some creative, and look, Nicki Minaj, Bees in a Track just came in, and, Nicki Minaj is a Sag. So, it's like Bees in a Track. You could create, like, a Bees in a Track type of environment for mothers, for feminine energies to be able to express themselves through dance, creative art movement, whether you're pregnant or not. You could create dance steps to where expectant mothers can still, like, move around, do some exercise, have some energy, build up their energy again, like, still feel sexy and in control. Because it says niggas ain't shit and they don't mean nothing. No motherfuckers can't tell me nothing. I bees in the track. Like, yeah, absolutely. Like, you're the fucking shit. Like, you bees in the motherfucking track. You don't need... Niggas ain't shit. So, I mean, if you crying over a nigga, like, this ain't your last chance. Like, you can meet another motherfucker, like, the next damn day, you're a damn Sag. Like, y'all be on the move. So, it's like, if they felt like you limited because you pregnant or you just had a kid, like, they don't know a damn Sag. Because my mom... I'm gonna be 100% honest. Like, my mom had me when she was 17 years old. Well, she had just turned 18 because I came the next month. My mom left my dad when she was 5 months pregnant. Like, she was not going. She's like, I'm not about to be sitting up here crying. My mom was on the move. That's that natural Sag energy. Like, all right, well, you ain't about to do right. Deuces. And she did meet somebody, the love of her life. I mean, at the end, it didn't work out because they had a lot of, like, my mom still had a lot of growing up to do or whatever, but she did learn a lot in that relationship about what it means to be nurtured by a man. I will say that. But it wasn't her last chance. My mom is married, like, you know, so there is men out there that will vibe with you on your level. But you need to first get true to you about what it is that you want in a partner. If you want a partner to inspire you to do this creative movement, to be able to move with you, to be on the same page and vibing with you, then you need to go within and check with yourself and check yourself, like, hey, does this partner align with me? Because, you know, like, bees in a trap. Like, you know, ain't nobody bees in a trap. Like, ain't nobody trapped. And you try, and if you think, you know what I'm saying, like, if they think trapping you with a kid, or, you know, I'm gonna be real, some of you guys think trapping somebody with a kid is gonna, like, work out. It's not. It's like, because do you even like that person? Do you want to be trapped with that person? 9 times out of 10, no, because you were crying in autumn, in September, possibly. So, you know, we have here balance, spirituality, and practicality. Full moon in Pisces. That's that high priestess energy. And that's coming out in your soul space. Balance, spirituality, and practicality. You need to be practical so that you can go within and have that higher perspective. And the mind space, jump in to calm your mind because luck is on your side. New moon in Sagittarius. That's your energy. Luck is on your side if you focus on your energy. Dance Tonight by Lucy Pearl. So, yeah, you guys are... I played my dance playlist for a reason. So I could get you guys your energy, your creative energy, and your mind space flowing. And I feel like as a Sag, like, if a Sag is hosting a motherfucking event space where they doing creative dance and coming up with creative moves for motherfucking expectant mothers, post-expectant mothers, and, you know, different type of phases of pregnancy for mothers, as well as, like, women who just want to, you know, move, get back into the flow, or women who just want to get into a flow, I would be there 100%. You get my motherfucking money, period. You're very close to achieving your goal. Gibeous moon. So y'all could take my idea. I don't care, because you know y'all Saggies are the shit, period. And then, so you're very close to achieving your goals. You talk about autumn is your last chance. All paths lead to home. So whatever path the universe pushes you on is going to help you achieve your goals. You just need to go with the flow. The universe is pushing you to a path of leadership. And they're guiding you. You're maybe uncomfortable and fearful about where it's going to lead you, but it says surrender to the divine, full moon. So surrender it. That's that hangman energy. So it's time for you to surrender. All right, so let's get you counting me and a couple friends. I love this song. Don't need to settle down. My body don't know how. Yeah, some of you guys are attracting in new love or new energy that gets you flowing. And it's like, but you've been in something that you were holding on to thinking that was it, and something else is sparking you up. So it's like, you know, it's got your body moving. It's got you feeling good, feeling some kind of way. So maybe right about now, during your birthday month, it's time for you to surrender that hangman energy. We got 12-12. So today could be significant. 12-12. Surrender, and it's right across from each other. I mean, I can't make this up. You seeing what I'm seeing. Maybe you ain't seeing. That's the surrender card. This is the hangman card. So, I mean, 12-12. Today, surrender it, because luck is going to be on your side. You'll be able to achieve your goals if you balance being practical. Like, does this, whatever you're going through, practical for you? And does it align with your spirit? When you align with spirit and you take practical steps to follow what the spirit is guiding you to do, like, you're gonna be a leader. If I just gave you a creative idea, hell shit, I bother. Just make sure you send me a little inbox message invite to your little creative dance class. I can go shake my ass. I don't have any kids, but in the future, if I do have kids, I'm at that class. I'm just saying. We have chained and bound in the soul space. Addiction and codependency are affecting your current situation or relationship. You may feel trapped in a connection situation and environment. Someone may act possessive and controlling. Okay, so you're in a possessive and controlling situation. Okay. And we got Slave For You by Britney Spears just came in. And that was in her early days, where she kind of was chained and bound to family, friends, traditions, people who were claiming they had her best interests at heart. And we all saw how the hell that all worked out. So, I mean, take a page from her book. In the mind space, it says you need to have self-love. Accepting and loving yourself is key in either attracting or maintaining a healthy relationship. Focus on what makes you unique without comparing yourself to others. You are unconditionally loved by the universe. So the universe gives you unconditional love. That'll help you get your good luck back. If you can calm your mind and then jump into whatever, and jump into this self-love, which will spark your creativity, bring your fire energy back. And in the 3D space, autumn is my last chance. You're very close to achieving your goals. All paths lead to home. It's time to say goodbye so you can go back to yourself. The situation or relationship you're in is facing a dead end. It's time to move on and let go. All endings bring new beginnings. So for you to have a new beginning, you got to go through a death, an ending of a situation, and to a rebirth. And they're telling you surrender to the divine. And overall, it says divine counterpart. Okay. So this person is your divine counterpart. You are connected with each other on an astral level. This connection helps to release the vibration on earth. You will create positive things together. Okay? So, you have to surrender to the divine in order to... If this person is your divine counterpart, then you guys need some healing work to do. And you have to practice self-love, because your soul is being chained and bound in whatever situation. You could be in a karmic situation that you think is your divine counterpart. And the universe is telling you, you need to love yourself and say goodbye to that situation in order for you to manifest. It could be the same person, but you guys need some space apart so you can find yourself again. Because you can only come into union when you balance out your own masculine and feminine energies. You can't balance out your masculine and feminine energies if you're chained and bound or someone else feels chained and bound, you have to practice self-love in your mind to get your mind untangled in chaos. And that may be saying it's time to say goodbye to your desperation, because all paths are going to lead you home. If it's meant to be, it'll be. If this is your divine counterpart, then the universe wants you to surrender in order to manifest it in a healthy way. If it's not healthy, then, you know, it could be a karmic lesson or situation that you believe is your divine counterpart, but because you're not practicing self-love, you wouldn't know. Once you start practicing self-love, you'll see it from a different perspective, which is that hangman energy. All right, so we're going to pull a crystal for your soul, mind, and body space that's going to help you with this transition.
I'm a slave for you.
I still like that song, so. But you don't need to be a slave, okay? Okay. All right, we got... Okay, we got tiger eye. Cooperation, creativity, and luck to help you free yourself and free your creativity and have free your luck. We also have bloodstone, endurance, grounding, and action in your mind space. So grounding yourself, strengthening your mind so that you can take action. And then we have in the 3D space, for time to say goodbye, carnelian, power, sexuality, and motivation. To get your motivation, your fire energy back, this is like solar plexus chakra, your confidence, your self-confidence. For you to do that, yes, you need to release and surrender. And overall, we have intention, comfort, and transition from the power shell. So, yeah, I did say transition, and it popped right out. These are the four crystals that should help you in this transition process with whatever you're going through right now. It looks like some of you guys are ending something to start something new or transitioning to a new phase in life. So now we're going to pull your pyramid spread. I always do a pyramid spread for the birthday reading. So the pyramid I'm going to do is, let's see. I'm going to do a pyramid spread. I'm going to do 14 cards for you. Okay, so for my Saggies, my Saggy collectors, let's do a pyramid spread here. All right, pyramid spread. So I got you advice on your soul. I'm a spiritual alignment reader. So yeah, this is for you as an individual, not for love. I'm not a love reader. I want to help you achieve your best version of you in your life. So let's see what we got here. Sorry, my camera keeps going in and out. So let's see, we got two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 11, 12, 13, 14, and overall energy is going to be at the top of the spread. Okay, so I do see what happened. The overall energy is the Seven of Swords. Seven of Swords is Aquarius energy. You could be dealing with one and have that in your chart. Talks about lies, deceit, deception, sneaky behavior, treachery. So this could be you with a person you're dealing with. You're dealing with Aquarius, that you could have been dealing with somebody that was in that energy. They're a liar. They're always moving behind the scenes and doing stuff behind your back. But this could also be you. Self-deception, lying to yourself, lying to yourself and not being your true authentic self. And behind that was the Hierophant. So that's God coming in to give me confirmation that when it comes to your traditions, your spiritual beliefs, you could be lying to yourself, lying to others. Somebody could be lying to you or lying to others about what it is they truly believe. You're actually not on the same page with this person, or they're not on the same page with you. And that's what I was mentioning about this whole divine counterpart. You could be lying to yourself, or they could be lying to themselves, believing that that's what it is. And Teenage Dream came in. So it could be due to the Page of Cups. Teenage Dream by Katy Perry was on. So if you don't know Katy Perry, I believe she passed away from mental health issues. Some of you guys are having mental health issues because your mind is in chaos about some kind of illusion or lie that you're under. You could be deluding yourself, which is causing your mental chaos, about something in the childhood. Some of you guys need to heal childhood wounds. I'm seeing some abandonment wounds and abandonment issues here. But anyway, starting at the ground level space. Starting at the ground space here, we have the Tower, card number 16, which 6 plus 1 goes back to the 5, the Hierophant energy. So God is confirming, like, God intervened and tore down this whatever foundation you were building because it was based on a faulty foundation. It was false. And that 7 of Swords is at the top of the pyramid over there. The next card is the Empress energy, 3. Card number 3, Empress. So I did mention pregnancy, being the Empress energy, which is the Empress is the, there's one in the deck. She embodies all queens, Queen of Swords, Queen of Cups, Queen of Pentacles, and Queen of Wands. So she's attractive, confident, has high self-esteem. She's loving, caring. Her emotions are balanced out. She is financially stable and independent, loyal, committal, and she is also magical. She is also smart, wise, intelligent, and she's been through a lot, so she knows how to handle herself. This type of energy, it indicates that here the universe is trying to bring you into this energy. But you could, your belief systems could be telling you, like the 7 of Swords on top of the Hierophant, that in the past, the belief systems could be telling you, and I do see the 6 of Cups here in the past and the Page of Cups, like a teenage dream of yours might have been in the past that you want to be this Empress. And this Empress, as you can see here, is pregnant. So a lot of you guys could have been thinking of the belief system or in a belief system structure that told you that being pregnant was this foundation that you were building, that you wanted to build. It was a childhood wish of yours, but it was a lie when it comes to traditions. It doesn't align with you. In order to embody this energy, and twerk was on before. So a lot of you guys like twerking, you know what I'm saying? So maybe that didn't align with your belief systems is what, how you're supposed to be presenting yourself. Maybe you're supposed to present yourself in this Empress energy, but you're aligned to yourself because you actually have to put the spiritual work in and be aligned with the universe, as they telling you before, to actually embody this energy. If you have low self-esteem issues, feeling like, oh, you want to cling to a partner that's making you cry, you're not embodying Empress energy. And that's why the Ace of Cups is next. Ace of Cups, self-love. In order for you to have true love, you have to love yourself first. You will not have true love if you have no self-love. If you don't love yourself, then you're not confident that the universe is going to bring for you what you deserve. And in order to do that, in order to truly embody this Empress energy, you have to have self-love. So that was this Tower. That's why the universe divine intervened. The divine intervened. And then we have the Queen of Wands. You need to work on your self-esteem, your self-confidence, your get your magic back, okay? You have to work on getting this back, okay? Getting back your magic wand, your fiery energy. This is definitely you, Queen of Wands energy. And the divine is saying you know the truth. You have the truth. The divine has told you the truth. So you can't, this air energy, okay? It could be Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We have Queen of Wands, you're Sagittarius. So I'm taking that that's you. We also have the Empress, Taurus, or Libra energy. So things are balancing out because you need to learn how to love yourself, okay? We also have the Lovers here, so definitely you could have been dealing with a Gemini. This talks about choices in love, a spiritual union, a Lovers relationship. You could, your person could share different belief systems, and which is why it was making it difficult for you to come in a union. If you're the feminine energy, because I see the Empress out here, then you could be someone of fair skin. Your person is someone from a different race. And that's the person you truly align with. That's possibly your true divine counterpart. You could be confusing them with somebody else, based on a faulty foundation where you're lying to yourself about this because you're feeling like, in autumn, it's your last chance. And you could be dealing with a Gemini or have that in your chart. You have the Eight of Swords, which is, I talked to you about that mental imprisonment, that mental energy of trap, that feeling trapped and restricted energy. You need to go within, because you're keeping yourself trapped in this prison, mental prison. And then we have Page of Cups. This could be child. This could be, you know, I'm going to be real. Like, trapping somebody with a child, Page of Cups could be indicate a child being trapped in a mental prison, like being trapped at a young age, childhood memory, something that happened to you as a child, an apology or apologizing, being childish could be immature energy. You're in this, trapped in this immature energy. It could be something that happened to you at a child, and when you were a child or where you were a youth, possibly when you were 6 years old, that has you stuck at that age mentally, and you need to heal that, because look, you're obsessed. It's creating toxicity, codependency, addictions. You could be indulging in drugs. So this is very, very toxic energy. I don't know what the hell is going on with you guys, Sag. This is your birthday month. This is unacceptable. Yeah, the divine intervened to get you out of this, because it's like you lost yourself here. This is not healthy. You know the truth, though. You know it's not healthy. You know you need to do some healing. You need to do some shadow work. You're keeping yourself stuck. Then we have here the King of Wands. So the King of Wands is like divine masculine energy. Masculine feminine energy is flexible and fluid. Take it however it resonates. This divine masculine King of Wands, a warrior, somebody who is confident, sexy. He matches the Queen of Wands energy, right? So we have that over the Lovers. So this is fire energy. Sagittarius, Leo, or Aries energy could be dealing with another fire sign. The King of Wands and the Queen of Wands are counterparts, right? They're divine counterparts, divine counterparts. So you could have presented that energy when you first met, because this is the beginning. And then leading up to what occurred, you could have had choices in love, and one of them was your divine counterpart. What just came on? Replay, Zendaya. So, yeah, you're replaying something over and over in your mind about what happened when you were a child, or when you were at a childish age, at the age of 6, could be at the age of 8. We got 10 here. Any other number, we got 16 here. So, when you're in high school, that you had choices in love and you felt trapped in something, which is toxic. You could feel trapped now. And we got a lot of past life reflection that you're replaying over and over again. It's toxic and you're kind of obsessed with it. You need to let it go. And this is devil energy. I'm a Capricorn. Let me tell you, this is our card. Card number 15. It could be happening when you're 15. To master this energy, you need to redirect it towards something creative. That's why you have the Queen of Wands here. You have the Queen of Wands here. And then you have the Ace of Swords, which is over here. You can't really see it. It's over here, the Ace of Swords. So you need to get back into your energy and channel this devil energy into your, bringing back your fire energy, your creativity, because it is destroying your mind right now. And yeah, creating blockages and burdens for you, and or blocking you from your true person. This talks about burdens, challenges. It could be overwhelmed, guilt. So you need to do some healing work, because you're being possibly blocked. This could be something that happened in the past. Something have to do with a child. With a choice in love, you could have chose the wrong lover that you thought was your divine counterpart, and it wasn't. This person was just a burden to you and a blockage. This is also your energy, that you're being weighed down by something. You're weighing yourself down. You see, you're in this, on this donkey. What is this, a donkey? So it looks like a bull. So you could be dealing with a Taurus or have Taurus in your chart. So you're burdened by possibly a Taurus, or blocked, or you chose a Taurus and that was not your person. They were just a blockage from your actual person. You had two choices but you're choosing to play it safe. This may have happened in autumn where you chose to play it safe instead of choosing your actual counterpart. And you need to say goodbye to this blockage or burden so you can get your divine counterpart. You need to find your inner strength. Card number 8, okay? True inner strength. Be truly, authentically you. You have to find your inner strength, courage. Talks about confidence. That's Leo energy. I have Leo in my chart. I definitely do. So you have to embody that energy truly, authentically, in your way as a Sag. To get yourself out of this burden, blockage, energy. And when it comes to, we have next the Six of Cups. This is something that talks about reconciliation, past life memories, soulmate relationships. Could be a karmic relationship as well. But good memories, childhood memories. So something that happened in the past, you're possibly replaying over and over in your mind. It's distracting you from and slowing down your own progress towards your goals. You're closest to achieving your goals. You've been working at it hard, putting hard work and dedication and taking your time. You're very close to achieving your goals, but the universe needs you to surrender because whatever you're working towards, you were lying to yourself about, or somebody was lying to you. Somebody's lying, and it has to do with a belief system. Somebody was lying about a belief system, and God came in to bring in the truth and tear down this foundation because this was bounding your soul. It was not you being authentic to yourself. You were confused because you were already trapped in a mental prison going over and over and over and over again over something. And you were creating a blockage and burden for yourself, okay? You need to get out of this energy. This is not Sag energy at all. There is hardly no fire. There's not a lot of fire cards here. There's a lot of air energy. This is mental. There is one card, one pentacle card. Oh, Lord. There is one pentacle card. And that's the Knight of Wands. The Knight of Pentacles. That's the slowest moving card in the deck. The pinnacle person has a reliable, stable offer, but it's about practicality. And this is, I think of Taurus, but you see that horse in there? This could be you following somebody else. You're following behind somebody else. You're a horse. And that may be why I mentioned Knight of Wands, because that's fire energy. That's not even your energy. You're not being authentically you. The horse is following somebody else. Since when? The horse is following the damn man. When? The horse is supposed to be riding away, doing what the horse wants to do. And the man, if the man want to follow, the man's got to tame the horse. The horse don't need to be following no damn body. What the hell? I'm just looking at that. Yeah, and just slowing down. There's only one. Look, just burdening yourself and placing the baggage on this bull. Or this bull is carrying somebody's weight. It's just slowing you down. Drop all this burden, this baggage. Is this keeping you stuck? There is one pinnacle card on the table. So that's what I mentioned. Balance, practicality, and spirituality. We do have a lot of spiritual cards here. We got the Queen of Wands is seen as very spiritual. We got the Tower. We got the Empress. We got the Ace of Cups. The Divine's trying to give you self-love and true love, trying to bring it in for you. We got the Ace of Swords. All these are spiritual cards. You're aware of these spiritual messages. You're not being practical, that whatever it is you might be working on or working towards might not be in your highest good. And you already know this. The Divine gave you the truth. The devil energy is in here. So you're not properly taming and getting a hold of this. It's devouring you. It's devouring your soul, your spirit here. And you need to pull out of this with this Queen of Wands energy. So no stopping me. What it just came on? Because same old love was on before. I'm so sick of the same old love. Exactly. And now we have Ariana Grande again. Some of you guys like Ariana Grande? Monopoly. So yeah, you're playing Monopoly, but you're slow. This is slow moving energy and you're falling behind somebody else. So it's like, you know, if you're not leading and forging your own path, this person's got the pinnacle on their back. The pinnacles are coming out. You see that? The pinnacles are coming out of the bag. Look. And you're following behind this person. The pinnacles are dropping out. You could be picking up these pinnacles and going off and forging your own path. Look, you see this? You're falling behind this person with the pinnacles in their bag that's dropping out. Just wasted. By the time they get where they're going, they're going to have this one pinnacle. Your horse following behind them. The pinnacle, you think the pinnacle is going to stay behind them? You're just following behind this pinnacle. This pinnacle might go somewhere else. Then what you going to do? You're going to waste all this time when you could have been grabbing up even one of these pinnacles and going on about your way and using this to follow you, lead your own path here. But you can't because you're stuck, burdened, overwhelmed, and obsessed. You're stuck. And why? Because of something that happened in the past. In the past, when you were a child. You got to let that go. It's time for you to free yourself. It's time for you to free yourself. Get back your confidence. Use carnelian. Power. Power. You see that? Power, sexuality, and motivation. You have lost this. What is your motivation? Ask yourself this, okay? So, that's all I have for you right now. So, please like, share, and subscribe. I did want to pull one Divine Feminine and Divine Masculine for Feminine Saggies and then one for Masculine Saggies, okay? This is a more, like, if you are in a Divine Counterpart, because Divine Counterpart came out, I feel like I need to do this so that you can have some clarification. So for my collective Saggies, I'm pulling this on the side because I got a lot of cards out on the table. Okay. All you worried about is pussy because you lost. What is this? You ain't got no money, so what you come for? Give me S. Give me money. Queen K. I was just talking about money. Like, it's only one money card on the thing. So that's crazy. Recognition. I know you. We are twin flames. We belong together. Just because you recognize your person and or remember things with them from other lifetimes doesn't mean they do or that they even agree. Let it be. Let processes unfold and cycles conclude. Know what you know. Stand in that power. And even if you feel like you're standing alone right now, you aren't, even if it feels that way. Use the gift of this energy for your own healing, soul growth, expansion, and ascension. Do not force energy. That's what I was getting. Don't force energy, feminists. You cannot do that. Just because you may recognize something, that person that you feel is your twin flame has to come to their own conclusion. The more you try to force it, the divine's coming in. And they could be telling you, no, you're toxically obsessed. This is a karmic cycle. This is not your twin flame. You know that. Because if it was, you wouldn't have to force it. This person could be a divine counterpart. You could be a divine counterpart. You don't know for sure until you surrender to the divine if the one you believe is your divine counterpart is actually your divine counterpart, or if you didn't choose the wrong one. And that's the worst thing you want to do, is be trying to force energy and you didn't even choose the right person. Now your divine counterpart is out there somewhere, possibly with somebody else. So be authentically you and be true to yourself. Go within and do some soul searching. If who you think is your person is really your person. Now I don't know, only you know that. So this is for, you know, those very spiritual Sagittarius. And most Sagittarius tend to be very spiritual. For the masculine, we have accountability for actions and choices. Many times I have not stepped up to the consequences of my actions. I've been in denial of the truth. Surprise, surprise. The true divine feminine will not hold you accountable to this sacred contract. She will let you go if you want to go. You have enough to be accountable to already, correct? You either remember and acknowledge this eternal twin flame connection or you don't. And if you Don't, the divine feminine energy will not force you into anything. Unconditional love does not force or coerce. She will walk away. She will do so with a very heavy heart and tears overflowing in her eyes, but she will do so. So this is what I mean. You have recognition. The feminine energy has recognition. You may be with somebody who is a twin flame. The feminine recognizes that this person is a twin flame. And the masculine recognizes they need to take accountability for their acts and choices. But the Queen of Wands is here. And the King of Wands is over here. Over here with the lover's energy. If this was your twin flame, they should be next to each other. You could have chosen the wrong one. You both could be twin flames, but of other people. Because if you aren't willing to walk away, you are not in divine feminine energy at all. Because you're not even embodying your own power and being a leader. You're following. And there's only one pentacle card, meaning the divine feminine balances that Queen of Pentacles energy, practicality. That's that devil energy I talked about. Queen of Pentacles can manifest with this devil energy 3D success. You cannot embody that following. You have to forge your own path, okay? So, yeah, now that's it. Please like, share, subscribe. I don't know what's going on my Saggies, but hey, I got the music for you. I got the music. I got the moves. Rain Over Me is that Pitbull is on. So, hey, Rain Over Me, let it go, release, do what you got to do, roll around. But it's time to release, surrender to the divine. And you guys will be all right. Just dance it off. Get creative, Saggies, all right? So I love y'all. Thank you for visiting my channel, and I will talk to you soon.